Good afternoon, everyone. I am so incredibly excited to be here today. So before I begin, I just want to consciously acknowledge the fact that it is very hot, and I am the main impediment between hundreds of people and boba, but worry not, I will do my best to be short and thoughtful. So speaking alongside someone as reflective as Dr. Boyle is a high honor. And while I know my wisdom pales in comparison to hers, I hope that I can impart something valuable for everyone to take home today. I want to begin my speech by describing one of my favorite memories from last year, one that took place just over this past spring break. On a day trip out east, I hiked up Cuyamaca Peak. Upon making it to the top, I found myself at the far end of the summit, a place void of any other human beings. Sitting there alone, perched 6,500 feet in the air, I stared across 100 miles of sunny skies straight through to Mexico. Forests and houses and highways all blending together into San Diego's interminable suburban savanna. It was breathtaking, but the majesty of the view was not what stuck with me. Instead, as I sat there, listening to the backdrop, rustling trees, distant crows, the occasional flourish of wind, there was silence. For a minute, everything stopped, tucked in a blanket of complete and utter peace. What's even more striking to me, though, is how vividly I can recall it. The Scottish philosopher David Hume argued that human memory derives principally from what he called impressions, raw, intense sensory experiences from taste to pain to pleasure. The strongest sensory experiences, he thought, left the deepest imprints on our memory. And for those who are in AP Euro, I'm sure some of those vivid memories are now resurfacing. It's striking then that the experience I remember most from the past year was rooted not in its intensity, but instead in its antithesis, silence. I suspect, though, that I am not alone. For many, silence has been the defining feature of this pandemic. As such, during the transition back to school over the past few months, the one thing that has struck me more than anything else has been the noise. Walking on campus, formerly a somber affair just a few months ago, is now filled with shouts from the theater or laughter emanating from the terrace. For the past year, silence has been framed as something for us to overcome. Hearing the noise of normal life is a vindication of our collective strength and efforts to fight this pandemic. We can see the light at the end of the tunnel, and the white noise on life's standard soundtrack has begun playing again. I am particularly drawn to the way US Poet Laureate Tracy K. Smith described it. The light we've only ever imagined, now audible, thrumming, marbled with static like grisly meat. Without the silence, though, I don't know if I ever would have appreciated the noise. Over the past 4 years of high school, I am incredibly lucky to have met everyone in the class of 2021, the kindest, most thoughtful, and most generous people in my life. I am also forever indebted to our teachers, who make me question whether I will ever be able to find the same electric learning atmosphere that I have found here. In a normal, noisy year, I'm not sure if I would have been so in tune with every moment. In forcing us to reflect, however, silence is often the way we find our truest selves. Only through silence can we begin to appreciate the noise. As of today, we only have a few short weeks left of high school. With that, I leave us all with one more question. What can we reclaim from this year of silence? The answer, I think, is quite simple. Whether in class, on stage, or on the field, we have made it through 4 years together. After a year of silence, I feel equipped with a refreshing awareness, not to view this final month with sadness, but instead as a time of collective camaraderie, a gift to spend with amazing people on this beautiful campus, a moment to make noise. Looking toward the future, I'm sure every one of you shares my feelings of brooding nervousness and cautious optimism. What's certain is that college will bring us many more sensory impressions that are worthy of you. Yet, as we all venture into the unknown, grappling with uncertainty and entropy, let's not forget silence and its remarkable effect of reclamation and reflection. Let's not forget how we can use yesterday's silence as a vehicle to live out tomorrow. Tracy K. Smith ends the poem I quoted earlier with this couplet. Silence taunts, a dare. Everything that disappears, disappears as if returning somewhere. Everything that disappears, disappears as if returning somewhere. With that, let's appreciate the silence we've had together. Let's reminisce in our collective memories and look forward with wide eyes, steadfast in our hopes, our fears, and our future. And now that we've taken a moment of silence for that, let's make some noise for the cum laude inductees and the class of 2021. Thank you. All right.